Finally to adventuring. Different time of year, perhaps. Spring at last! Look how beautiful the land is! I'm not taking horses. Robert Black sneezes loudly. Stupid flowers. I doubt we can go south, but I might as well check the border there. We won't be able to reach High Marsh this way. Let's head west. Go close to the avalanches, of course. Why is Robert so slow compared to Creosa? Not sure how we're gonna deal with the dragon. Robert might have made the deal with him, or it. But he never paid. So I'm not, certainly not gonna pay him either. Well, depends on the price, I suppose. And depends on, are we gonna just avoid a fight, or are we gonna gain an ally? They're refugees here.
Hold up there, lad.
What is it, Captain?
We've got trouble, that's what. Something horrible attacked our city.
Stone Guard has fallen.
I don't know. Everything's a mess. It all happened so quickly.
I was coming to speak with your king. Is he okay?
He's in the inn just there. Talk to him. He probably knows more about what's going on. Look, I've gotta keep watch. I've got a lot of refugees coming through here.
Alright, thanks, Captain. So, proper attack through the lower levels.
Greetings, adventurer.
Lord Ramir, you are sight for tired eyes.
Hello again, your majesty. Sure to be meeting with you once more under such circumstances.
I don't recall our circumstances becoming quite so dire before, but nonetheless, I'm glad to see you. And I'm honored to have the princess here, though I think it might be a bit too dangerous for you, Creosa.
Though your concern is touching, Majesty, it is also misplaced. Like Ramir, I am here to help.
What exactly happened here?
I remember those Duergar you fought recently. Well, it seems they were only a scouting force, aiming to find our weak points and harass our operations. Our dark cousins have returned and in much greater numbers.
So they're like sand. And they routed your military in a few short hours. I find that hard to believe.
It is true, but there was something else at work there. Something sinister, and I think I know what it is.
Oh?
Would you excuse us for a moment, Captain? I need to speak with Lord Ramir in private for a moment. At once, sire.
What is it, Majesty?
It isn't widely circulated, but I'm almost certain that a dragon is leading the enemy force. I don't want that to be spread around, though.
From underground or above?
Under. It was organized in the Duergar that were attacking. Only a small number of my soldiers knew about it, so I decided to keep it that way.
That's a dangerous plan.
Information about our enemies is vital to field commanders.
What did you plan to do about the dragon?
We have in our possession a number of powerful magical weapons, one of which is quite suited to fighting a beast such as this.
Dragon Slayer Blade?
Correct. I gave this to our foremost warrior and sent him with a small contingent to slay it. It was 15 hours ago, so I do not believe they were successful.
We could use that sword to fight the dragon along the Caldany Highway.
I would be willing to let you take it if you can find it and use it to slay the dragon trying to take over my city. Agreed.
What sort of sword is it, and where was it last?
It is a bastard sword. The dragon was heading toward the royal chambers the last time I heard of it, so there is a good chance the sword could be found around that area.
I won't be able to wield it, it's far too heavy for me.
Then hand it to me. I can use any weapon you'd like.
Excellent. You do realize that means you'll be the one doing most of the fighting.
The thought had occurred to me, yes. I knew what I was getting myself into when I signed on for this, and you're not going to hear me complain.
No, I'm glad to hear it. Alright then, Your Majesty. I think we have a plan. But I have a feeling the dragon has not only slain your warriors, has taken the blade and hidden it. It's a powerful weapon, even in the hands of its allies, is unlikely to be tolerated.
Quite possible, but I'm still relieved to have you on our side. This has been a shock to all of my people, and if the dragon and its Duergar allies aren't stopped, they could cause a great deal of trouble for the entire region.
Guess I'll head down and lop its head off, then.
I'm sure you'll return in triumph. A contingent of my warriors are guarding the main gate into the city. They'll help you get in there, but the lower level itself is lost to the Duergar scum. Be careful. You won't have any reinforcements when you're down there.
Thanks for the info. When I return, there is something else I would discuss with you.
Of course. If it's important, perhaps you'd prefer to tell me now, in case, you know.
Unnecessary. I've faced Duergar before, and I'm confident I'll beat them again. Still, if I do fall, the dragon and its forces may be sorely weakened. Do I not return? Hit them with everything you can muster. No. I doubt I can convince him to send any warriors to High Marsh unless his home is secured first.
I will finish what you start, I swear it. But let's hope it doesn't come to that. Fortune to you, Lord Tremere.
See you soon. I don't recall if Duergar are able to do sneak attacks. Might be better to have Robert have the sneak attack immunity armor if they can. Right. I need this. Not to spill my armor class is so piss poor. Right, both of them have natural armor benefits coming from other locations, so no point giving them the bark skin. Stone skin on the other hand. Sure what to expect. Be able to buff my armor class a little bit more. 36 without using the good expertise. 46. It's a respectable amount. It won't protect us against truly great fighters. A trash, probably yes. A fighter will have around attack plus 20 at this point, maybe a bit more. So you definitely need something 40 or above, otherwise forget it. Guard Captain's Office. They seem easy, but that just means there are a couple levels lower than me and probably fighters.
Attack, I say! Hold this spot. This spot right here.
I can do this.
Get on them! Attack, I say!
Yeah, they have 21. I can tank them, but I definitely need to use the expert mode. There's just a half a dozen warriors, I think, nothing more. Now I'm tanking like 4 of them. Still getting hit on a regular basis. Yeah, critical hits. What do they have on a 48? So they need about. They need a more or less a critical hit to hit me at all. However, that goes right through all my defenses. Without about that. Why aren't you actually attacking someone? Just do some attack nearest. Why the fuck is the nearest somewhere here when you are hugging enemies? Ugh, for fuck's sakes, you stupid bitch. Guard me, maybe?
You're in for it now!
Fair enough.
No. Why the fuck is it so hard for you to do anything?
Fair enough.
Blood and glory!
I'll kill you! You'll see!
Like the fact that I changed my voice set apparently accidentally too. I don't dislike the voice set, it's just dislike the fact that I accidentally changed it. It's takes surprisingly long to kill a couple of Dwarves. The levels are just starting to be so high that everyone is gonna have hundreds of points of health. What's the improved expertise? Right. Three of them bled.
You are not worthy!
For some reason they try to go after targets that they can't really attack. While they're basically right next to targets that they can attack without any trouble. So I'm not quite sure what the attack nearest does. It clearly doesn't attack the nearest. Let's go on the offensive. Right, I'm definitely buying the extra damage. Elemental damage on the three. Probably be closer to 50% damage increase. This takes forever to kill anything here. Kriosa is not that good of a rogue. So she can't dish out the same amount of damage as our previous one. Not sure if we want to cleanse this place. We're getting like 100 points per kill, 120. We are getting something, but to be fair, it's not that great of an amount. It takes a huge amount of time to kill them. So maybe better to try to go after the dragon. Still,
no quarter.
Probably need to rest here anyway. I'll go and try to block them here. Someone has to tank them. Since we have the extra hitting power from other guys, I might as well be the one. Because I can rely on myself to do it. Yeah, but that's the thing, I'm not. It's not a good place for us though. I'm blocking all the attackers. Still, enough people get to attack. So it's not too bad. The biggest problem here is the narrow hallways. Now that we have the number advantage, we can't actually leverage it. Well, I'm usually on the other side of this particular situation, so no complaints. It makes sense that underground fight would be like this. Narrow corridor, so the fight would be of certain nature. Princess, could you come in here? It's on the trap, maybe? You don't have to hide behind the door, no one's judging you, just
in step, follow me.
Get on them! Attack, I say!
You are a rogue, aren't you? this trap.
Well met.
Let's talk about tactics. Our AI should be able to detect that.
I can do this.
Just let it go. A gold necklace.
Get on them! Attack, I say!
Well, I don't know where the weapon is. I doubt it's here, but I don't exactly have a lot to lose by taking a look. A trap in this room, but that's what was distracting her. She could sense that, but no way to access it.
Finished. I'll see what I can do.
I do want everyone else to help me with the bashing and the light. Finished. That's why I don't want to tell to the AI not to help. Sometimes, yeah, just lockpicking it is a good choice, but not always. Sometimes we just need to get things moving. Right.
You're going down.
Hey, thanking five of them now.
You're going.
This will work fairly well. These guys should be killed. There's one problem with Robert Black. His critical hits are fairly weak. He got a great critical threat roll and still only 26 points of damage. Yeah, you get double damage with a bastard sword. That's weak. Well, if it adds elemental damage to that, it also gets an increase, and it'll turn quickly to 30-40 points of damage. It'll still work. And we're fairly in a sweet spot as far as the tanking is concerned against these. We're regenerating, I think, almost as fast as they do damage to me. So, as long as they attack me, they'll lose. I need to change positions.
You're in for it now!
The dragon is here. probably in the main hall. Right. We're gonna have to fight these 5-6 man groups a lot. We'll fight. It's not like I have a huge amount of options. But we definitely are gonna want the weapon upgrade. Two down. Three down. But it's not that bad.
Clavier skull.
Right, I'd say this high probability we're gonna get a level up out of this. We get a little bit of something by just finishing the job. And, we're getting maybe about 600 experience points for every group we kill.
This whole area is compromised. Expect traps, fortifications, the works.
Finished.
Get on them! Attack, I say!
Attack, attack. Throne room. It could be that the sword is there too. But it's a large enough in an area for the dragon to be. Let's do this. Find traps. Three traps disarmed. We're gonna use it 3 times per day. And if we disarm it, we get some experience too. But we can use it here without a doubt.
I can do this.
Let it
get
go.
On them! Attack, I say!
I'll rely on the 3-5. It's a fucking door, just let it go. It's a door, let the fucking doors go. Jesus Christ with you people. Locked door is not that big of a thing. I'll rely mainly on the 3 times per day item and use the wand of trap detection as a backup if we need to. Hopefully we don't have to rely on it, but if we do, it's fine. That's what it's there for.
Hold this spot. This spot right here.
No, don't hold this spot.
Get in step.
Fair enough.
Follow me.
Here, you pieces of shit.
Get on them!
I don't want the wizards to join the fight at the same time.
No quarter!
Gurgar Captain. Okay, he probably has the sword. I'll just tank him.
Forget the relic. Kill those bastards.
Okay, they came from the throne room. So that's where the relic. Good. Please don't have the mages join. If these guys are holding us back and there's two wizards pummeling at us, that's gonna go bad for us.
Time to die!
And there. Shit. Lost a lot of armor. And I'm pretty much dead. Concentration failure. Ugh. Use the heal. It's a fairly dangerous situation. I'm taking massive amount of damage constantly. Critical hit. Left. Yep. Yeah, I got healed, and I had took some damage, and now I don't have any health anymore. Yeah, I'm not gonna survive this. It's the wizards. You fucking people should have just listened to me and retreat. I need to basically focus my entire effort on keeping myself alive. But if a Duergar captain goes, that might give me a chance. I'm not in good enough shape to cast anything healing. No! The wizards are both here. Excellent. Fuck you, wizards. Four wizards! No wonder the elemental damage was this tough. Tank. Just more. You fuckers. Spell disrupted, right. Well, that was pretty much impossible to... I would have needed to roll a 19 to be able to not get disrupted. So much damage coming our way. Fucking wizards. And this was all because of the fuckers wanted to fight so close to them. Okay, the expertise doesn't really do anything for us here.
I will not fall!
Using missile barrages, save versus gold failures. Oh my god, this is just a catastrophe. I'd rather die and load and refight this than waste the rest of my healing potion. The problem is, they're not that tough, but I have to use all my time in trying to heal things. So nothing is, please just fucking die. I mean, my own character. End the suffering. Well, that's... 3 deaths? Someone got paralyzed.
All fun and games.
So hard to say what the fuck is going on. Could you attack someone? Right, what a fucking catastrophe. Well, we still survived, so that's something. But, not worth the resources. And if I had any kind of proper offensive capability, or would have started casting before the huge amount of wizards got piled on top of us, that would have been not a problem. They're not that tough. We're gonna need all this equipment though to buy back all the lost supplies. Creeping Doom would have been just fine. Something to disrupt them and go through their magical protections. Also, I'm not going to need the Dwargar Captain's corpse. He probably has something worthwhile.
Well met. Hello.
Heal. Dwargar large shield, plus 4, immune to paralysis. Wait, God. Battle axe plus... Wait. Big problem with defense-focused equipment sets and builds. The single offensive spell would have basically cut down the need to have these defenses. Right. Also, proper command capabilities for your companions would have helped quite a bit. Commoner.
Well, hello there!
Thank the gods, you found me at last!
Easy now, you're okay. Why didn't you evacuate with the rest of the population?
My daughter was sick and I needed to make sure she got to safety. I stayed a little too long though and couldn't make it upstairs without catching the attention of the Great Wars.
I see. Well, you're clear to get out of here now. I suggest you do so.
What are you doing here anyway? Are we taking back the Undercity?
Maybe, maybe not. I'm scouting around mostly, but you need to get moving.
I'll get out of here right now. I know there's at least another 3 of us down here, hiding. Find them, please.
Do what I can. I'm going to have to rob you too.
I'll see what I can do. Finished.
Get on them! Attack, I say!
And it just mysteriously turned to dust, did Robert. Right. I do like the fact that their spellcasters' first instinct, basically, when they saw me there, was disable my buffs. That's a big problem with some campaigns with the combat AI, where you can just buff your average character to ridiculous height and then walk over the enemy. When they could basically strip all of that away with a single spell. I would imagine that the relic is on a named corpse or in a locked container.
Hello there.
Yep, you're clear to head out.
Do you know of any others hiding down here?
There are probably three others down here that I've seen.
Don't want to engage the dragon. Someone appears to have been searching for something.
Well, hello there!
Saved at last.
That you are. You've got a clear run to the exit upstairs. I suggest you take it.
Okay, but you've got to stop the Duergar. I heard him talking about looking for some kind of a scepter in the city, but they ain't found it yet.
A scepter? Strange. I recall the king saying there weren't any in Stoneguard.
Well, I hope he can sort it out. I'll be going now. Thank you for your help.
Are we talking about the same scepter then? Scepter of Transcendence. Because that was just a ruse. Although we never got the idea of where the addition to the book was coming from. I mean, I know who did it, but was it just shit he made up? The locations then also seem to be just guesswork. No quarters.
Yet. You're in for it now.
Oh no, sparkle traps.
Have it.
Leave your skull.
You're going down.
Yeah, we're. If we don't use the expert mode, we are just going to get so many hits. So many hits. Three capable fighters pummeling at you, so that tends to happen. And I don't have the natural armor's bonus, so a weaker armor class too. Do I have artificial way to increase that? Nope. Greater Amulet of Health doesn't really provide much protection here. I mean, none of them are using anything it would protect against. So, do we have extra amulets of natural defense? You're using a slashing weapon and it comes right through. And I think I have, yeah, soft plus 3. This cloak is worthless. Ooh, Ring of Appraisal. That's an interesting choice. Not sure what ring would help, but regeneration might be nice. Need to keep healing. Bad selection of equipment really for an encounter like this. Does anyone have an extra amulet of natural armor? I sold all of them. They were fairly weak though. I don't think selling them was a bad idea, I just think we need to keep an eye out for extra ones at this point. Plus 4 is something we would like. Anything to push armor class above 40. Less just isn't gonna cut it.
I can do this. I'm done with this.
We do have to rest. I'm not going to fight a dragon in my current condition.
Well met.
I know for a fact they've been led by a huge dragon. I saw it as I was fleeing from the mines. Huge it is.
I see. Well, you've done your part anyway. Best head up to the surface.
I can do this.
Well, hello there!
Black dragon.
Oh, no, I don't think so. I've seen a black dragon before out in the Calisper mines before we moved out here. It's once evil to be sure, but it's no black.
Interesting. I'll be careful. I'll get moving. Is it a shadow dragon? Oh, it could be a red dragon, I suppose. Would have fairly good defense against a red dragon. Didn't find the sword. Didn't give it access there though either. I'll take another look. Maybe I wasn't paying attention. We ain't getting through here. Maybe I need to go and check the corpses in their prison cells.
I'll see what I can do. Finished.
Get on them! Attack, I say!
I'll see what I can do. Finished. Finished.
Yeah, if they're in prison, they probably had their weapons removed. He did say throne room. On the way to Caldony, I'm going to take a crack at that huge blue dragon that's blocking the road. Likely to be a top fight, so I should remember to stock up on equipment for facing it. I'm gonna take another whack at the throne room. Check the dwarven corpse we encountered. I don't recall any mention of a specialized named character. Maybe they farmed the item and someone special, the guy is holding it. Right, where's Robert? In jail. His natural habitat, apparently.
Attack, I say.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Robert. I'd like to finish this level before resting. The dragon in the deeper ones is a different issue. About 1,000 experience points we'll get before we get to level up. Elite to druid power ups. Should get offensive spell casting going up.
Perhaps I should wait here. No. I'll not stand by while you fight this beast.
Fallen Dwarven Knight. That's it. Lightbane. Shadow dragons prefer to attack from hiding, employing their natural abilities to blend into the shadows. Negative energy. That's a natural nasty shield. MacTavish standard. Large shield, plus 4, only usable by Dwarven Defender. Spell resistance 26. I think the highest so far I've seen is 18. But it's a Dwarven Defender only.
Oh,
Draconis, bastard sword. Bonus damage versus dragons, 1d10, magical. Plus 6 versus dragons. Robert. You don't have any protections against this. It's gonna get slaughtered. Fuck. Anything I can do, realistically. It's gonna be fairly resistant to spells. And pop Robert if I can. Right, that does a huge amount of damage. Why is he so focused on me anyway? Well, retarded AI to the rescue this time. Now he did. Now he changed his attention. Don't think he'll survive though. Robert is hitting him fairly well. I can help a little bit. Negative energy breath. Better not take chances on this. Use heal. And that's pretty much the end of it. Yeah. No! I'll produce two weapons now. Fuck you, dumbass. Did I tell you to use two weapons? I did not tell you to do that. You stupid sack of shit. It's no longer doing magical damage. Well, the dragon was much easier than I thought. The head of this vile, of the vile shadow dragon.
Oh, someone give me a hand! This is too much to carry!
And there was much rejoicing. Although I would have had to rest, but still Duragar warriors here. But good luck with that.
The battle is on!
Yes it is. I give. Do I give though? This great dwarf is covering in fear as he approaches. He speaks in a broken form of Aielish.
No kill, I no fight.
I accept your surrender. Now, what were you people here looking for?
Light Banesayer, Lord of Iron coming. We need weapon. Light Bane scared, make us come here to fight hated enemy.
What sort of weapon was this Lightbane seeking?
Big scepter thing. Thought King Salinas had it. Could not find Lightbane angry, eat many Duergar.
He missed a few. So what do I do with you now?
I flee. Go home. Never return these cursed halls.
He did surrender. After being defeated. After fighting and losing surrender. I am a good aligned person. What exactly would the good entail? As an act of mercy, I agree to let you live. Be sure to tell the rest of your people what happened here and what will happen to them if they try to come here once more. I think that's a much more reasonable look. Stands to take than just letting him go. And thanks to him, we do know what they were here for. And I do want to encourage the thought that maybe if you do surrender and give up, it's not necessarily the end of the world, so...
Yeah, I go now.
Leave the Life Forge. Wonder why it's there. Either way, mission success. Maybe it was here or the previous types too, and I just didn't pay attention. That's very highly likely. Fine. Can become a better druid again. Animal empathy. Ugh. Yeah. How about something else first? Can I get Tumble? Yeah, that's an extra armor class point for me. Persuade would be nice. Lore would be nice. Healing would be nice. Let's go with Persuade. Wild Shape, 5 times. Leave. Get extra attacks here and there. It's not super good though. But I'm not sure if we have great options here anyway. Maximize spell might be nice. Resist energy. No. It's like 5 points, I think. And, at this stage, you're just getting massive amounts of energy damage if you're taking it. It won't protect it against spells. However, if someone does a little bit of extra elemental damage on a weapon, then it might be somewhat useful. But, spell penetration. No, a maximized spell would be better. Extra bark skin. Although Cat's Grace was very nice too. Right. Nothing new. I don't think the hold monster is worthwhile. Here's the thing, none of the monsters you want to hold are vulnerable to that. And the game relies very heavily on mass combat. I mean, a lot of copy-pasted Duergar troops here. It's justified from a role-playing perspective. The point is, a single one-target spell is not gonna make any fucking difference. I need either something that buffs us or does damage to a group or protects us. So these single-target things, they're way too situational to be of any real use. Don't work on bosses, like 90% of the time. And even if they do, they have high enough saving throws that they would have to have a critical failure for it to go through. So it's largely a waste of time. Be a little bit of area of effect. Fire damage. Half divine. No, I think I'll just take the stone skin. It's because I need to buff companions constantly. Drill the wall of fire. I'll take spell resistance. The target creature has its spell resistance set to 12 plus 1 per caster level. So at this point it would be 26, 27 something. The target already had a higher spell resistance, the spell has no effect. It should last for an entire fight. It's not gonna protect us from spells or make us immune to spells. However, it should allow us to deal better with those situations like we had, where there were quite a few mages just pummeling all kinds of shitty spells at us. A significant number of those would have just fizzled and never affected us. Drown also fairly situational. I think the higher level buff spells might be better. Stonehold might be good. Creates a cloud that paralyzes any creatures inside it. I think we're pretty much immune. The princess is not. But otherwise we're immune to paralysis. Drown is not particularly useful. A single wizard, if that was the target, then something like that would be nice. Or a high-level rogue, maybe. But in any group fight, not so much. Greater Gat Cat's Grace. Which means I'm not taking another cat's grace here. The bark skin then. Summon creature is sort of worthless too, but this would be an elemental. Aura of Vitality. Plus 4 bonus to strength, constitution, and dexterity to everyone around you. It doesn't last too long. But still. Harm. That's a priest thing. Good spell. Maybe the Firestorm. All enemies within the spell's area of effect are inundated with a rain of fire. Take 1d6 points of damage per caster level. Half of the damage is divine, and the other is fire-based. Against fighters, this would be mainly if we have, again, large group of casters. Interrupt them. The Creeping Doom does sort of the same thing, but I don't think I... Well, actually, I don't know if I can stack it. It's 14-15 points of damage every round, and that's not much, but another one of that. Again, no saving throws, no spell resistance. Something to think about. Firestorm would be a higher burst. I think I'll mix it with... No, I think I'll... I'll try to see if we can stack the Creeping Doom. That could be very nasty later on. Assuming that it keeps going, the damage keeps going up per caster level. And it has no ceiling. We could get closer to 20-30 points per round from a single Creeping Doom cast. That's a lot of damage that you can't resist in any way. Except through damage resistance. Right. Support our success. Any kind of healing besides high level healing kits and full heals are pretty much worthless in a fighting situation. Should I investigate these? I doubt there's anything interesting. There might be a Duergar or two still left. Now's a good time to do any looting. The dwarves are hardly going to object. Just contributions to the war effort. Right. We'll probably have to do something similar for the barbarians. We'll have to think, are we gonna pay... What I think is gonna happen is, are we gonna pay the dragon, the other dragon, or are we gonna fight against it? Don't really have an opinion on it.
Hail to ye!
Hold up there, lad. What are you doing down here?
Here to help. What's the situation?
Pepe, don't see what he can do about our problem here. A whole damned army got routed by the scum.
Let me worry about that.
All right, enough theatrics. What's the situation, Captain? Okay then, this is the only safe point left on the upper level. Undercity's been overrun and they've closed off the mines by collapsing the entrance.
What the hell did they do that?
We ain't rightly sure. I do know that a great number of our boys were down there battling them, so maybe they cut him off after a fair number of them got through. Of course, they could also be mighty stupid cutting off their only way out. Take your pick, I don't care. There's also a number of civilians gone missing too. We're keeping an eye out for them.
Okay, I'm heading down. Give me backup.
As soon as that gate is open, they're gonna try and swarm through. So yeah, me and the boys will surely help.
And repeat of the same shit. Right. We need to focus on upgrading our weapons.
Greetings, adventurer.
Hello again, Lord Tremor. Have you any news to report?
I returned as promised, along with the head of the dragon.
You've slain it. I knew I could count on my friend. You've saved our city from occupation from those scum, and for that you have my eternal gratitude.
I'm not particularly lawful. Stability of the region, my ass. Gratitude's fine, but I'm a big fan of cash rewards.
So am I. A big, big fan. Of course. I'm sure I can part with 5,000 gold pieces for your trouble. What will we do?
That's fine, thanks. But my real reason for coming here in the first place was to gain your help in a coming battle. I don't know if I want to press him on the Scepter of Transcendence nonsense, because clearly they didn't find it again. So maybe it's just a rumor that they too heard. And I really need their help in the war effort. So I'll just try asking for help in the coming battle.
Oh, where is this battle taking place?
Most likely around Fort High March. That's where the army is gathering in any case. We need every spare warrior you have. Can I count on your support?
You have it. Where do you need them?
They need to be at the Fort High March within 2 weeks.
I think I can work with that timeline. We'll need to secure our city first, but I should have the army marching south by the end of the week.
Thank you for your support, Majesty.
Excellent. On behalf of my people, I thank you for your assistance in this troubled time, Your Majesty.
I appreciate our good relations with the Kingdom of Aielund, whose people have always been kind to us. You have come to our aid on more than one occasion, and it is with pride that I am able to finally repay you in kind.
And I will see your army in Highmarsh soon. I regret that I must keep moving, Majesty. Events are unfolding even now that require my presence elsewhere.
Quite all right. I'm going to have a busy week myself. Well, farewell to you, Lord Tremor, and good luck.
Either way, rest. Give me rest. Where's the innkeeper? Is there an innkeeper? I don't know. Maybe I can just rest.
L-T-E.
There.
Well met.
So next is the dragon. I don't know if I need anything special for it. I mean, it's not a dragon at the head of another army, it's just a dragon. I'm sure it's more deadly dragon though. But outside of a couple of healing potions, which I probably can't buy, I don't know what else I could take. I don't recall the city having anything that interesting in it. The one ring, the fire ring. Elemental fire ring. Fairlock. Let's try this. The stone recall glows softly in your hands. What do you wish to do? Set this location as a recall. So we'll run into the city. Do what we need to do, then use it to store the recall back here.
Otano for Digama.
I'm gonna buy the Ring of Elemental Fire. Not sure if I want it or if it's gonna be useful, but. And there's the butt. I don't want to have that butt there. I'd rather waste some money than have the butt there.
Hi.
88,000. It's gonna be around that no matter what. Let's trade. This space 12,000 at maximum. I do have some items that I know I can just dump. We don't have a dwarf. Only usable by dwarven defenders. It's a great shield, but no one can use it. Morningstar Flame. I must still prefer the flame damage. It has a respectable enchantment bonus too. A lot of backup equipment. Paralysis immunity. Give it to the princess. And manually put it on and off. The point is. No. She cannot use it. Don't think she can use a shield. We have paralysis immunity through other means. Well, I could give the belt to the princess to give her paralysis immunity. Then use this shield myself, so the entire group would be immune. 1 point of armor lost. Not too big of a sacrifice. I'll keep the bastard sword plus 3 for now. Suppose I can use the greater swordsman's build. The damage reduction soaking is worthless. Everyone has plus 3 weapons at this point. That it? I did take these daggers for the express purpose of recovering a little bit. Still have 180,000. The situation by any means is not bad. Right. So you can place the recall point for free. Returning to the recall point is what costs you the gem.
Get on them! Attack, I say!
Right. There's the monastery here. I'd like to visit that. Surely nothing's bad going on there, but then there's the bodies. Not sure if we should visit the cave. At least ask them what's going on. Tell them we're going after the dragon. Buy all the healing potions.
At least this magnificent valley has remained untouched by the flames of war thus far.
Anything new happening here?
Yes.
Robert, I see you have returned for another visit. Hello, Draco. Don't worry, I'm not staying long. You've been here before? Yeah, I spent a few weeks here recently. How are you faring? You seem to be physically recovered. I'm fit enough, sure. I think I've got the hang of swinging a sword around without taking my other arm off, too. Fighting with one eye is challenging. Of course, then that matter we discussed. I'm dealing with it right now. Rammer and I are heading down the Fort High March.
What are you talking about exactly?
Nothing, it's personal. Come on, get what you came for and let's keep moving.
If I didn't know you better, I'd say Robert had an attack of conscience.
He did mention that sort of thing back in the jail cell.
Okay, you figured me out. Mystery solved. I felt bad that I'd attack Colony for profit. I'm here to make amends, got it?
Ah, the big tough mercenary has a big soft heart.
Apparently so. Now enough with the Inquisition already. Get what you came here for and let's get moving.
You're a complex man, Robert.
Maybe there's hope for him yet.
Okay. Maybe there is, Princess. Maybe there is. Drago, I see that the bridge across the river is still locked.
Correct. The dragon that has made its home in the mountains west of here remains a constant threat, and I do not wish for people to travel there until it has left.
Strangely enough, that is exactly what I'm here for. I wish to pass the bridge so that I can confront the dragon.
You are planning to fight it?
If I have to, there may be other options.
It is good to see that you have kept your mind open to other possibilities.
Indeed. So can I have the key, please? I'm in a bit of a hurry.
I understand. Here, take it. I wish you good fortune in your imminent confrontation. You will need it.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. I still need to see your inventory. Ah, Boots of the Hurricane, Dodge Modifiers, Dexterity. This has no relevance to us. Neither does this. Alright, give me all the potions of heal. How many? 7 lesser restorations, we don't need more. I'm thinking of buying a... Do we have bark skin? It's not particularly strong, but in an emergency situation where all our natural bonuses have basically failed, we don't have spells to cast to replace it. I'd like to have a bottle or two ready to rely on. Also, the potion of clarity saved our ass in the dragon fight. Buy a few extra ones. Potions of speed. Sure, I want to buy these. Might have a couple already. Right. Just haven't been using them. They don't last for long. Rod of anti-magic. We have the previous anti-magic item. Healing kits. What do we have? Like 15? I'm not gonna get flagged for copyright infringement because the Eska Flone chant keeps going on here. Right. Good enough. A little bit of an upgrade, extra healing supplies. I'll quickly go and check if we can go into the caves again. I would imagine no, but currently the game seems to be funneling us pretty heavily toward High March. And I'm fine with that. If there truly is nothing for us to do here, it would be better to just funnel us there, right? Otherwise, it's just an additional waste of time to go explore these sites that have nothing to offer us anyway. So another dragon confrontation. I'm not exactly short on cash. But I doubt the dragon is going to take another check on his services. So we might have to fight it.